All right, so what we've got doing here, or going on here, is we've planted a couple of seed cells on the blue surfaces, and those represent sort of petri dishes where we want the cells to grow. We call those attractor zones. On the other hand, we have up here at the top this red zone, which is a keep-out zone. So what just happened is the seed cells grew towards their target in the same way that plants grow towards the light and water, the roots grow towards the water. That's their purpose in life. And so what this part is doing is effectively growing to support the loads that are being applied right now. And as it gets strained, which you can see in the colors towards the yellow and red, it screams out to its neighboring cells. So these cells are talking with each other and communicating using what's called morphogenics, which is the way cells talk using chemical signaling. And we have captured that in the software. And the cells are responding to the strain by throwing off child cells. So in the same way that an astronaut who's been in space for months comes back, or maybe weeks, comes back to Earth, the bones naturally get stronger in the areas where the strain is built up. At the same time, you can see that the areas where the cells are not needed are being eaten away, and you can literally see them falling on the ground. And this is all happening in real time. At some point in this process, when it's grown, we decide that we want to take this and actually output it and print it. So we have the ability to smooth it, and what we're seeing here is a rendition of the mesh that is ready to print. Right? The other thing that we can do that's very important is model different kinds of loading conditions. So for example, we can go in here, let me just switch this to a mode where I can find my models. So in this case, what we're doing is we're growing this part towards this location that's going to have multiple forces applied to it. And the importance of this is that we can handle the multiple load cases, which in this case corresponds to a torque, which I can change here, bounce it up and down. You see, the part really doesn't like that. It actually has a mind of its own. It will grow in response to the changes I make. It's very educational. If you're trying to understand the magnitude of a change, for example, if I want to see what happens if I pull this towards me, I can simply change the magnitude of the slider, and it builds essentially flanges on the part. Once again, this is very interactive in real time. The other thing that we noticed that was very inspirational in this was